Five County Stadium, the Carolina Mudcats staff rolled up the red carpet one concluding time in 2019. August 28th began with a routine weather delay, just as the team itself was under an unusually dark cloud throughout the month. In fact, the season sun was set on 16 losses, the finishing 21 games. Good enough or bad enough for last place in the standings. But this is never the last place you want to spend one more fading summer night. In now familiar roster country. So when it's about to end, how about we end with a win? That's it. That's my show sales pitch. This is starting slinger Scotty Sinichis. He went headhunting for the top of the Southern League mound down the stretch. Strikeouts over 10 frames. Departed high single A, undefeated at 2-0. It was a crackling first frame for him, ushering in the Mudcats' initial opportunity to hop on the board. Terrain. Rob Henry. And Pat McInerney swatted some souvenirs before surrendering an order. Sonich issued two walks in the second, but nothing else. Carolina bowed in 1-2-3 fashion. Sonich responded with equal and opposite force. Meanwhile, the Mudcats were still 0-for offensively.
Yes, sir.
Sonich strummed and hummed along with three fans in his fourth. The Mudcat batters suck a time up, prompted an upswing.
Yeah.
As Terang broke up the rivals, no hitter. Then McInerney took a do-over to leave the park in fair territory. A 2 RBI dinger. A still scrappy bunch scratching out a lead. Sonich maintained near total control, extending his own no-no to 4.2 innings. prior to this, no doubt, Dream Smasher Gapper. He recovered nicely and retired as the winner. Conceding the conquest to the bullpen. Reliever Matt Hardy caused a pop to burst Fayetteville's two-on bubble in the sixth. Carolina's league-worst strikeout bugaboo persisted in its next plate appearance. Yet Terang triggered a rally by walking, then stealing. Notice his foot barely beats the tag to his hand. Again, McInerney delivered him home in the clutch, even putting an ixnay on the relay. Hardy quickly benefited from the vastness of center field space. And Zach Clark's ability to navigate it. That's wallop to wall coverage. More trouble was slow and brewing. But it appeared on a two-bagger with two gone. cue of bang, bang, yay, yay, play at the plate. Celebration to the local tradition. After that seventh inning stretch, and upon loading the bases, Rodriguez absorbed a beanball for the team. And for a point. Our Legion was well in the red. Fayetteville next faced Phil Bickford, the hottest hurler on the circuit. 26.2 straight scoreless innings. Along that terrific tear, he netted 39 whiffs versus just 6 walks. Look out. Out looking. Gotta admire this artist's strikes of genius. Because there were plenty of them to go astound. That'd be no comeback, just a Henry splintered comebacker. While McInerney continued waving his stick of dynamite.
All right, we'll get you one out. All right, be ready.
The Woo Birds were chirping. while he was firing. Going out on a high note, this would prove to be the Mudcats' swan song in the victory department. Five straight defeats would follow. But the gone are not forgotten. Courtesy of your MC's curtain closing call. The penultimate home game left me with an ultimate thrill.